Everybody, and welcome back to the Upper Room. This week we're talking about the luminous mysteries. These are times in Jesus' life where he shed light on our faith for us. The first luminous mystery is the baptism in the River Jordan. Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist. Upon Jesus emerging out of the water, the heavens opened up and the Spirit of God came down like a dove and rested on him, giving Jesus his mission to save the world. Just like him, when we are baptized, we too receive our mission, and the old us dies, and the new us emerges out of the water, and we keep a new name called Christian. And the second luminous mystery is the wedding feast at Cana. At the wedding, the bridegroom and the bride had run out of wine. Mary came to tell Jesus they were out of wine. Jesus said to her, "What does this mean to me? It is not yet time to reveal myself." The stewards had asked Mary to ask Jesus if there was anything that he could do. Mary turned back to the stewards after asking Jesus and told them, "Do whatever he tells you to." Regardless of the fact that Jesus wasn't ready to reveal himself by performing this first miracle, he did it anyway because his mother asked him to do it. Just like the stewards trusted in the intercession of Mary, we too learn to trust in the intercession of Mary as we meditate on this holy mystery. The third luminous mystery is the proclamation of the kingdom of God. Jesus told everyone that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, turn from your sins, believe in the Son of God, and convert from whatever religion that you're practicing now into Christianity. Believe in Jesus Christ and follow him. And the fourth luminous mystery is the transfiguration on Mount Tabor. Jesus brought Peter, James, and John with him up to the top of Mount Tabor. And there his clothes turned dazzling white, and his face was changed. And there Elijah and Moses appeared. Here we learn that Jesus communed with the saints, as it is also okay for us to commune with the saints and ask them for their prayers, for God for surely hears them, for they are righteous and holy people. And the fifth luminous mystery is the institution of the Eucharist. At the Last Supper, Jesus held up the bread and broke it and said, "This is my body, broken for you. Take of it and eat." And then, in a similar way, he took the chalice and held it up and said, "This is my blood, the blood of a new and everlasting covenant. Take and drink in communion with me." For Jesus said, "He is the bread that has come down from heaven. Not the bread that their fathers before them ate and died, but whoever eats this bread of his body and his blood will live forever." This concludes the luminous mysteries. We pray these mysteries on Thursdays of every week. I hope you enjoyed them. I hope it was informative. I also would like to take this time to mention that my new book is out, Our Ordinary Lives Hold an Extraordinary Purpose. You can find me on Amazon, barnesandnoble.com. You can look up by author Jared P. Bisson, or you can look up by the title, Our Ordinary Lives Hold an Extraordinary Purpose. Please pick up that book. There's lots of informative information in there on the history of the church, the history of the sacrament of reconciliation, and the purpose of the book is to bring a sinner to repentance, to discover your spiritual gifts, and ask God what your mission is so you can execute that mission. Thanks again for watching The Upper Room. I'm Jared. I'll see you again.